Hello everyone, welcome to my channel which is Learning Institute, and today I am going to discuss about the Compton effect and pair production and the comparison between Compton effect and photoelectric effect, also the pair production in empty space as well as in matter. So let's start the video. Photoelectric effect versus Compton effect. In photoelectric effect, absorption of photon of an electron metal system, demonstration of energy of photon, that is equal HF, here F is the frequency, so this is the photon's energy HF. And from conservation law we can write MEC square plus K, this is before scattering, equal MC square, and K is nothing but H nu minus work function. Here nu is replaced by F, so F is the frequency, so this is nothing but K is equal to HF minus W. Similar here in Compton effect, scattering of a photon by a free electron, demonstration of both energy and momentum. Here is only energy, not the momentum, but in the Compton effect, energy as well as momentum. So we can see here, this is the strike target. Target atom, which is generally electron, or electron is in free space in this case, and in photoelectric effect electron is in the bound state. So this is the basic difference between Compton effect and photoelectric effect. The Compton electron is free and the photoelectric electron is bound. So this is the incident photon and then scatter, and recoiling electron has the energy MEC square plus K. K is comes from the striking. After scattering, this K is added to the electron. Initially we suppose in this case the electron is in the rest, that is electron's rest mass energy is MEC square. And after scattering, electron energy is MEC square plus K. So this is the structure, incident ray of photon scattered and recoiling electron in this direction. This is theta. Theta is the scattering angle. Lambda is the wavelength of incident photon, and lambda dash is the wavelength of scattered photon, and this is the X-ray tube from where the X-ray photons are emitted. The spectrum of scattered X-ray contains not only the original line but also the shifted line. Not only the original line but also a shifted line. We can see here for theta equal 90 degree, this is the original and this is the shifted line. This is the original, this is the shifted. So this wavelength lambda is original and lambda dash is shifted wavelength of line. The wavelength shift, and this is also saying lambda dash is greater than lambda. Lambda dash is greater than lambda. The wavelength shift, that is Compton shift delta lambda, depends on theta but does not depend on the target material and the initial X-ray wavelength. The effect could not be explained within the framework of classical physics. Compton and Debye successfully explained the effect of considering the single act of elastic collision between an X-ray photon and a free electron. So this is a single act of elastic collision between X-ray photon and a free electron, single electron and X-ray photon. So this scattering is not by the atom, not by the metal as in the photoelectric effect. This is by only say single electron, that is free electron. To absorb the effect, the energy transfer from a photon to an electron should be relatively large for two reasons. तो इन दिस केस जो एनर्जी ट्रांसफ़र होता है प्रोटॉन का वो काफ़ी ज़्यादा होता है. उसके दो रीज़न है. फर्स्ट, द वेवलेंथ शिफ्ट शुड बी मेजरेबल. द वेवलेंथ शिफ्ट शुड बी मेजरेबल. एंड सेकेंड इज टू कंसिडर इलेक्ट्रॉन बाउंड इन एटम्स एज फ्री पार्टिकल्स. द ट्रांसफर्ड एनर्जी शुड एक्सीडेड फॉर द बाई फॉर द आयनाइजेशन ऑफ light atoms. So in this case electron is in free space. चूँकि electron free space में होता है तो उसे निकालने के लिए या ionization करने के लिए energy use नहीं होती, इसलिए ज़्यादातर energy transfer हो जाती है और electron recoil कर जाता है और photon scattered हो जाता है. जबकि photoelectric के केस में photon fully absorb होता है and then electron का emission होता है. For a large transfer in an atomic collision between a photon and an electron, the photon energy should be large, comparable to mv naught c square, but a reasonable fraction of it. The conservation of energy equates the sum of energy before and after the scattering. So this is the before scattering total energy and this is after scattering total energy. So E gamma is the incident photon energy, EE is the electron energy, electron rest energy, and E gamma dash is the scattered photon energy and EE dash is the recoiling electron energy. Compton postulated that the photon carry momentum. Thus, from the conservation of momentum, the momenta of the particle should be similarly related by this equation. That is P gamma equal P gamma dash plus P E dash. Here P gamma is the momentum of gamma ray photon and P gamma dash is the momentum for a scattered photon. And PE dash is the momentum for recoiling electron. The momentum of before the collision, the momentum of electron before the collision is a zero because initially electron is rest, at rest. This is assumptions that electron is initially at rest. So PE is zero. And after scattering, electron's momentum is this PE dash. The photon energies be related to the frequencies by E gamma nu, E gamma dash equal HF dash, where H is Planck constant. Before the scattering event, the electron is treated as sufficient close to being at rest and that its total consists entire total energy consists of mass energy equivalence, that is equal mc square. After scattering, the possibility that the electron might be accelerated to a significant fraction to the speed of light requires that its total energy be represented using the relativistic momentum relation. This is the relation, relativistic energy momentum relation. So after scattering, electron has the energy EE dash, which is equal to rest mass energy plus kinetic energy, or simply energy, because in this case potential energy is zero. Expand the conservation of energy statement in the form of this. So HF plus MEC square, HF dash plus this is the EE dash we put here, EE dash. On squaring both sides and the post scattering electron terms on the left side, so this term is here. Now from the conservation of momentum, then by use of scalar product, we can write as PE dash equal P gamma minus P gamma dash. This is simple momentum of incident gamma ray photon minus momentum of scattered gamma ray photon, that is equal recoil momentum of recoil electron. Now by taking scalar product, self scalar product, we get PE dash equal P gamma minus P gamma dash, P gamma minus P gamma dash, and this is equal this simple scalar product. Anticipating that the P gamma say is replaceable with HF, we know that this is similar with HF, multiply both side by C square, we get this. After replacing the photon momentum in terms of HF by C, we get this. Now equating equation 1 and 2, this is equation 1, this is equation 1, and this is equation 2, we get this. And after solving this, on dividing both side by 2f ff dash mec, we get this. And since fz f lambda equal f lambda dash equal c, this is c is the independent of before and after in any free space, is always c, is never changing. The lambda dash and lambda dash minus lambda equal h upon mec 1 minus cos theta. So this is the wavelength of scattered photon minus incident photon, and this gives the expression for Compton shift. Summary of Compton effect: when a photon enters matter, it is likely to interact one of the atomic electrons, not the nucleus, not the metal. The photon is scattered from only one electron rather than from all the electrons in the material, as in the case of photoelectric effect. The laws of conservation of energy and momentum applies as in any elastic collision between two particles. The momentum of a particle moving at a speed of light, that is P equal to E by C, is HF upon C, and this is CF equal to H upon lambda. The electron energy can be written as, and this yields the change in wavelength of the scattered photon, which is known as the Compton effect. So this is the Compton shift, and this equation shows that this shifting is only depend on the theta, and theta is the scattering angle, so it not depend on the metal, it only depend on the scattering angle theta. But the photoelectric phenomena is depend on the metal. This is also a different from the Compton experiment. scattering Compton effect. Electrons and nuclei can scatter photon. Scattered photon is at lower frequency than incident photon. As we discussed earlier, जो हमें वेवलेंथ मिलती है वो ग्रेटर देन होती है. इंसिडेंट फोटोन से तो इफ लैम्डा डैश इज ग्रेटर देन लैम्डा देन न्यू डैश इज लेस देन न्यू. तो स्कैटर्ड फोटोन इज एट ए लोअर फ्रीक्वेंसी देन इंसिडेंट फोटोन बिकॉज सम ऑफ द एनर्जी इज ट्रांसफर टू द इलेक्ट्रॉन और द न्यूक्लियस. क्योंकि कुछ एनर्जी लॉस हो जाती है इलेक्ट्रॉन को रिक्वायर करने में या न्यूक्लियस से इलेक्ट्रॉन को रिक्वायर करने में. दिस इज द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द वेवलेंथ ऑफ स्कैटर्ड फोटोन where lambda dash is the wavelength of scattered photon, lambda is the wavelength of incident photon, m naught is the rest mass of particle like electron, theta is angle of incidence. Scattering angle, theta is the scattering angle. Example, X-rays of wavelength 0.140 nanometer are scattered from a block of carbon. What will be the wavelength of X-rays scattered at 0 degree? So by this formula we can solve very easily. Lambda is equal 0.140 nanometer and theta is 0 degree. So we can simply put and solve, we get the 140 nanometer. So this lambda dash is greater than lambda because lambda is only 0.140 nanometer and lambda dash is 140 nanometer. Another example, what will be the wavelength of the X-rays scattered at 90 degree? And this is comes to be lambda dash equal 142 nanometer. Simply after simplify we get. And another example, what will be the wavelength of the X-ray scattered at 180 degree? And this is equal 145 nanometer. So this is the longest wavelength of scatter photon we see here in 90 degree 142 nanometer and in 0 degree we get lambda dash as 140 nanometer. And for 180 degree, because we know that the scattered photon, yeah, scattering Compton scattering is only depend on the scattering angle, so for 180 degree more and more wavelength. So shifting is observed, shifting सबसे ज़्यादा मिलती है 180 degree के लिए. Pair production and annihilation. If a photon can create an electron, it must also create a positive charge to balance charge conservation. तो अगर हम ये माने कि photon एक electron को create कर रहा है तो वो ज़रूर एक positive charge भी create करेगा क्योंकि चार्ज कंजर्वेशन बैलेंस होना चाहिए. In 1932, C.D. Anderson observed a positively charged electron, E+, in cosmic radiation. This particle, called a positron, had been predicted to exist several years earlier by a P.M. Dirac, great scientist. A photon's energy can be converted entirely into an electron and a positron in process called a pair production. फोटोन एनर्जी इंटायरली कन्वर्ट हो सकती है इलेक्ट्रॉन और पॉजिट्रॉन में, और इस प्रोसेस को हम बोलते हैं पेयर प्रोडक्शन. बाय दिस रिएक्शन फोटोन इज इंटायरली कन्वर्टेड इनटू एन इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड पॉजिट्रॉन. सो चार्ज कंजर्वेशन इज आल्सो बैलेंस्ड. हियर इज चार्ज जीरो बिकॉज गामा हैज नो चार्ज. And here plus and minus cancel out. This is the pair production. Positron, electron. Incident gamma ray. Pair production in empty space. Conservation of energy for production in empty space is like this. HF equal to E plus plus E minus. E plus is for positron and E minus for electron. So considering the momentum conservation, this will give HF equal P minus C cos theta for electron and plus P plus C cos theta plus this term is for positron. This energy exchange has the maximum value. HF max is equal to P minus C plus P plus C. But recall that the total energy for a particle can be written as, so this gives a contradiction because HF is greater than P minus C plus P plus C. Because here is P minus C plus P plus C, but also this term cos theta minus and cos theta plus. So this will give the HF is greater than this value P minus C plus P plus C. So this is a contradiction, and hence the conservation of energy in empty space is an impossible situation. तो ये एक असंभव की स्थिति है. सो हम कह सकते हैं pair production empty space में exist नहीं करता. Pair production in matter, since the relation HF max equal P plus C plus P minus C, this is for positron and this is for electron, and HF greater than this contradict each other, and a photon cannot produce an electron and a positron in empty space. But in the presence of matter, the nucleus absorbs some energy and momentum. So in this case, the photon energy required for pair production in the presence of matter is like this: HF equal E plus plus E minus, and this extra term is also in case of matter. So because of this, the conservation of energy law is balanced, and this energy should be greater than the pair of electron and positron energy, that is 2mec square plus mec square, that is electron and positron. So this energy is equal to 1.022. So if the photon has this energy, then the pair production is occur in matter. In free space cannot occur because the energy conservation is not balanced. In matter, pair production is exist. Pair annihilation: a positron passing through matter will likely annihilate with electron. A positron is drawn to an electron by their mutual electron attraction. and the electron and positron then form a atom like a configuration called positron. This is for positron and this showing electron, and both are annihilate to each other. Pair annihilation in empty space will produce two photons to conserve momentum. Annihilation near a nucleus can result a single photon. By conservation of energy, we can write 2 MeC square is nearly equal to HF1 plus HF2. HF1 is for positron and HF2 for electron. And for conservation momentum, we can write as before scattering, after scattering. HF1 upon C is the momentum of positron and this is momentum of electron. The two photon will be almost identical so that the frequencies are same, F1 equal F2 or F. The two photon from positron annihilation will move in opposite direction with an energy, this (0.511 mV). So this swing before decay and after annihilation, they are moving in opposite direction here and there, moving in opposite direction. Clear? Discussion of photon interaction. So here we discuss the relative importance of gamma ray interactions. This graph is showing photoelectric effect dominant and this area is pair production dominant, and in between this area is the Compton effect dominant. Z here we are showing the observer. So we can see here the photoelectric effect mostly observing case hai, jyadatar part isme observe ho raha hai. Pair production mein bhi totally gamma ray photon चेंज हो जाता है इलेक्ट्रॉन और प्रोटॉन में. इन कॉम्प्टन के केस में ऑब्जॉर्व नहीं होता, बल्कि ये एक हाई एनर्जी पे काम करता है. रेंज इसका 0.01 से लेके 50 MeV और उससे ज़्यादा एनर्जी पे पेयर प्रोडक्शन होता है. तो कॉम्प्टन का रेंज काफ़ी ज़्यादा है और यहाँ एब्जॉर्ब नहीं होता बल्कि ये स्कैटर्ड हो जाता है. तो एब्जॉर्प्शन शो नहीं कर रहा है, इसकी लिमिट इनफाइनाइट तक जा रही, यानी कॉम्प्टन का जो फोटोन है वो एब्जॉर्ब नहीं होता, स्कैटर्ड हो जाता है. ओवरव्यू ऑफ फोटोन एब्जॉर्प्शन क्रॉस सेक्शन. ए जनरल एक्सप्रेशन दैट इज बियर्स एब्जॉर्प्शन लॉ गिव्स आई इक्वल आई नॉट. आई इज द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ फोटोन और एनी रे equal to I naught e to the power minus mu x. I naught is the original intensity, x is the thickness of the material or target, where mu is the absorption coefficient. So different processes for different energies as shown here. Photoelectric effect E is less than 500 kV. Compton scattering is at energy, Compton scattering is at 500 kV to 5 MeV and pair production is produced when E greater than 2 mass of electron, 2 times mass of electron. So this is all about for today. I hope समझ में आया होगा. वीडियो देखने के लिए धन्यवाद. थैंक यू.